Hi everyone, it's Grayson here. It's been a while since I see you guys, my YouTube family, due to some personal issues, but I'm back. Here I am to continue to give you valuable financials content. And I intend and plan to do it a weekly posting from today now on, so don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button to see more great financials, business and investment videos. Don't forget to hit the notification bell as well so you won't miss out any great content that I post in the future. In my opinion and point of view, the year of 2021 will be a year of rotations. A rotation is a financial term used by bankers, investors, and many financial institutions. The terms of rotations means that the investors in the market are bored and tired of the previous trend and they're trying to find a new investment to rotate their money into. So for example, like the COVID-19 year of 2020, everyone is going into the COVID-19 stocks. For example, like Zoom, like many technology stocks. But in the year of 2021, in my opinion, the markets, they are bought and tired of the old COVID-19 era and they're trying to find a new trend to invest into. So that is a rotate of the investors' money from the previous investment A to the new investments B. So today's topic is gonna be huge. It's gonna be how to invest in the year of 2021, and it is basically the beginning of the end of the COVID-19. So for those that don't know me, I'm a certified investment consultant here in Malaysia, and I'm also a stock investor just like you. So today we are gonna talk about how to invest in the year of 2021. It's the biggest question in our mind right now because, as you guys know, 2020 has been a very great year for us. So don't worry, I'm gonna analyze and do all the fundamental analysis to you, and we are gonna look into how we gonna invest in the year of 2021. I'm gonna give you a general plan to you of my 5 investment idea, so you can take the idea down and you can analyze yourself and maybe you can find a value or two inside it. So let's get into the video. The first investment idea I have for the year of 2021 is definitely watch out the working from home stocks because they're about to come down. The working from home stocks is basically stocks that people are buying a lot, or the product or services people are using a lot in the working from home environment, like this year, February until October. Do you still remember what happened to Zoom, the video conference company? What happened to their shares when the Pfizer's vaccine news came out? It drops about 20%. And that's the moment when I know the market are eager to wait for opportunity like this to rotate their money into new investments. Not only in the technology stocks, it comes back to many other sectors as well. For example, like food and technology. When people are working from home or they are staying at home more than they used to, they gonna order a lot of delivery services. For example, like Pizza Hut, like Domino's, like McDonald's, fast food like that. Because they don't want to eat out, so they ask for the delivery. And they use a lot of services like this, which cause the stock's price of those company goes up in the working from home era. But you have to think, if you are a shareholders of company like that, you have to think of another perspective, meaning are people gonna use delivery services or technology services as much as they used to when they are working from home? And if it's not, maybe it's time for you to rotate your money into investments that are in the trend in the post-COVID-19 era as well. And the second investment idea I have for the year of 2021 is travel stocks. I know when I mention travel stocks, a lot of you might think, but Grayson, we're in the middle of COVID-19 pandemic right now. Is it really wise to buy in travel stocks while they don't even have demands? Well, you see, in investments, it's always buy low, sell high. We have to be greedy when others are fearful, and we have to be fearful when others are greedy. This is what happened to the travel companies right now. In the middle of pandemic, everyone is selling out their travel stocks. Everyone is throwing out their travel stocks, and their price becomes so low. And if there's any travel company that you like, and they have very good fundamental and financials, this might be a good time for you to go into the market while the value is so good and they have such low price. And when we are looking into travel stocks, we need to look into 3 different segments. We can look into hospitality, which is hotel. We can look into business, which is airline. And we can look into leisure, which is cruise. And I believe with the opening of many countries' border and many restrictions are lifted, the travels demand is coming back, which will directly benefit to many travel companies. When I mentioned travel companies, there are a few names that come into my mind. For example, like Marriott Hotels, Hilton Hotels, Disney, Carnival Cruise, Royal Caribbean Cruise, etc. And the travel company I like the most in Malaysia here is Genting Malaysia. So that's probably something that you can look into. And the third investment idea I have is pharmaceutical stocks. When I say pharmaceutical stocks, I don't mean just any medical or any pharmaceutical stocks. I mean we want to monetize the idea of 2020 to until 2025 is the year of vaccinations of the COVID-19. We can look for a company like Pfizer, which is the first one that came out with the COVID-19 vaccine. From 2020 until 2025, many countries will buy vaccine from Pfizer. So it might be a good idea, and if you have the same point of view as me, we would monetize the idea of these few years, which is the year of vaccinations. Not just Pfizer, a lot of vaccines company. As you guys know, this year a lot of technology stocks has been booming like 100%, 200%, or even 500%. So if you guys know about FANG, F-A-A-N-G, which is Facebook, Amazon, Apple, Netflix, and Google, FANGs is a term used by Wall Street, used by many investment bankers to mention about the five biggest technology stocks. And all these five technology stocks having their best year this year just because of COVID-19, and the demand for their service has go to the rooftop. So this year, a lot of technology stocks, not just the top five, are going a lot of gains, and that is a sign of overvalued. And like I mentioned before, when a stock is overvalued, it might be a good time for us to withdraw our profits and we switch into another counter, or like I mentioned, we rotate it to another opportunity. This year, the technology stocks gain has been too unnatural, it's been too artificial, as in it's obviously been boosted by the market and by the many investors. So if you're having good gains right now, well, it might be a good time to consider if you still want to hold it, because the demand is not going to always be like this for technology stocks, especially if you are holding the top 5 company. And the fifth investment idea I have, well, it's hardly an idea, it's more like a reminder to us that we should always remind ourselves, is to don't overreact to the market. Because it's very easy to get affected emotionally in an unstable market like this, which every day there's news coming out positive and negatively, and it will affect our emotionally very badly. So it's very important for us to not overreact to bad and good news, and always prepare for the worst. Prepare for the worst not just mentally, but also physically. What we can do to prepare ourselves physically? Well, the very first thing we can do is always have an emergency fund. Having an emergency fund meaning like you have an account set up just for putting 3 to 6 months daily usage money, so you wouldn't ever run out of money because of your investments. And the second thing we can do is to don't all in into stocks market. The money that you put inside the stocks market must be the money that you are not going to use it in the short term. Don't get affected in real life just because of your investments. And the third thing we can do is something we call cost averaging. For example, if you buy a stocks A at $1 and today it drops to 50 cents, well, you can use the cost averaging method to buy at 50 cents, so your average cost will be 75 cents. So always have money for cost averaging, always have money for your emergency fund, and always set aside a part of money. Don't get affected in real life because of your investments. So that is what I mean by get prepared for the worst, but don't overreact to good and bad news. And that is my top 5 investment idea for the year of 2021. I hope you find tons of value in this video, so don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button to see more content like this. And don't forget to follow my personal Instagram at grayson.jy to get more updates. I'll be very active there, so don't hesitate to stop by and say hi. So I hope you stay safe out there and always take good care of yourself. See you guys in the next video.